Okay, so we've opened a fresh, brand new display using the New Display button in the top right corner of PyVision. Just as with our North Dakota overview display, we'll start by preparing our WellPad detail display before adding any dynamic content to it. Like before, we'll change the background color from a dark gray to white, and then create a text box at the top to indicate our title or purpose for the display. Here, we'll write WellPad detail. The text is a little small and difficult to read at the moment, so let's increase the font size to 26. Now it's time to add our Pi system data. We want our display to represent WellPad data in each of the North Dakota locations, so let's start by finding our first WellPad element in the asset tree. Drill down past the North Dakota element in the oil well production database, where we should find our list of WellPads: Crosby, Dickinson, Kenmare, Stanley, and Williston. Highlight the Crosby element and then locate the WellPad name attribute in the list beneath the asset tree. Make sure that you have the value symbol selected and then click and drag the WellPad name attribute onto the display. We'll drop it just below the WellPad detail title. By default, the value symbol displays the value, timestamp, engineering units, and the element and attribute names together as a label. It looks a bit busy at the moment, and all we really need to see is the WellPad's name, which is Crosby, so let's hide everything else. We can do so by right-clicking on the symbol and selecting Format Value. Then, under the Visibility section, we can deselect Label, Units, and Timestamp, leaving only the value visible. So far, this looks great, but since management is considered expanding the PyVision rollout beyond North Dakota to perhaps our New Mexico operations, let's make sure to include a regional identifier on our WellPad detail display too. This data happens to be stored in an attribute called Production Area Name, so let's find it on our Crosby element. And making sure that our value symbol is still selected, drag and drop it onto the display just to the right of our WellPad name. Like before, we'll clean up the symbol to hide the label, units of measurement, and timestamp, leaving only the production area name visible. While we're at it, let's go ahead and increase the size of both our WellPad name and production area name symbols so they're a little easier to read. To save us time, we can increase the font of both symbols simultaneously. To do so, hold Ctrl, and then click each one of the symbols in turn. Then, right-click on either of them and select Format Symbols. Notice that the option now has been pluralized because multiple items are currently selected. Let's bring the font up to 20 so the names are clearly legible but slightly smaller than the display title. Lastly, for this part of the display, we'll improve the look of the location data with some visual flair that better catches the eye. First, we'll straighten out and align the symbols by selecting both, and then use the Align Top option from the Arrange drop-down menu on the toolbar. What this will do is reposition all of the symbols vertically to align with the topmost member of the selected group. Then, we'll draw a rectangle around the two symbols using the Rectangle option from the Shape drop-down in the toolbar. Click and drag to draw the shape such that it encompasses both of the symbols with a small amount of padding inside. And then finally, we'll draw a dividing line between the two using the line symbol from the same shape dropdown. Note that if you hold shift while drawing a line, it will snap to the nearest 45-degree angle, which can be very helpful in creating sharp, clean lines.